myself, Dr. Bhaskar Virsas, Assistant Professor, Vidya Bharati College, Delhi. We are start a new portion, that is cost accounting. And cost accounting is a part of accountancy, another part of accountancy. There is three parts. First, financial accounting. Second, cost accounting. And third is management accounting. So cost accounting is a new subject. The meaning of cost accounting means those concerns are related to process of manufacturing, process of production, that concern maintain their accounting by cost accounting system. In cost accounting, there is a first topic as per Nagpur University syllabus, cost sheet and tender. So first define what is meant by cost. Cost means a manufacturing expenses. Cost means total manufacturing expenses. So there is another question. What is meant by manufacturing? So manufacturing means convert a raw material into finished product, means conversion of raw material into useful product, finished product, that is known as manufacturing process. Manufacturing expenses generally divide into main part, that is direct expenses, and another is indirect expenses. So direct expenses means those expenses are directly related to process of manufacturing. Those expenses are directly related to process of manufacturing, or a manufacturing process cannot start this type of expenses, that is known as direct expenses. And third, direct expenses means a manufacturing process start and completed by which type of expenses, that is known as direct expenses. So indirect expenses, there is a first part, material. Without material, we cannot produce any type of article. So material, another is labor. Without help, we cannot convert the raw material into useful product. And third is other direct expenses. Other direct expenses means in manufacturing process, rather than material and labor, use the various type of equipment, use the various type of machinery, and expenses on that part is known as other direct expenses. So material used in manufacturing process, that the formula, that is the consumed material means opening stock of raw material, means in our factory, in our manufacturing unit, there is a stock of raw material. The manufacturer first consumed, that is known as opening stock of raw material. But this stock is not sufficient. The further material purchased from market. So second factor, purchases of raw material. At the time of purchases, the manufacturer paid various types of taxes. In short, that is known as outcry. Paid a traveling charges is known as carriage inward. Paid wages at the time of a temporary coolie, that is known as cartage, dock charges, and sundry expenses at the time of purchases should be added, means increase the cost of our product. And the addition of this factor, unused material, means in manufacturing process, which material is not used, that material is known as closing stock of raw material, should be subtracted from our total cost. As well as at the time of manufacturing process, there is a scrap, there is a wastage. That scrap and wastage should be subtracted from our total cost of material. And finally, we receive a material which is used in manufacturing process is known as consumed material. So this is the part of material of direct expenses. Second part, labor. There is three types of labor generally used in manufacturing process. Skilled means a group of labor who have a knowledge of that particular manufacturing process, that is skilled, semi-skilled means they have no knowledge, but partly knowledge is known as semi-skilled, and third, newly labor, that is known as unskilled labor. So these three types of labors are generally used in manufacturing process. So another part of manufacturing expenses, that is indirect expenses. The definition of indirect expenses is very simple. Those expenses are not directly related to process of manufacturing. Means those expenses are not essential for the process of manufacturing. But the manufacturer spent on money on that type of expenses is known as indirect expenses. So indirect expenses generally divided in three parts. Factory overhead, another is office overhead, and third is selling and distribution. So factory, office, selling and distribution is not essential for the process of manufacturing. But manufacturers spend a lot of money on these three heads. So purpose of factory, the protection of their labor, protection of their machinery should be provided by factory. And that's why provided the various types of provisions, the manufacturer increases the level of his production. So he spent a lot of money on factory. So factory expenses also increases our cost of manufacturing product. Second, office overhead. The distribution of work, they use the office, means contact to customer, contact to government, contact to public. They spend money on office, they establish office and work from office. That expenses also indirectly affected on our total cost of manufacturing. And third, selling and distribution expenses. Selling and distribution expenses means manufacturer sold his product by himself. But my friend, it is not essential to sell our product by ourselves. We can supply agency, we can supply a dealer, we can supply to direct market. But manufacturer decide if the selling and distribution process followed by himself, the cost, the total cost or profit margin, it is affected. And if the applying or using the selling and distribution process, adopting the selling and distribution process, the profit should be increases. This factor known by the manufacturer, so he spent or he processed the selling and distribution by himself. So factory overhead, office overhead, selling and distribution overhead is adopted by manufacturer. So it should be increases our cost of production. So these are six main head which is affected on cost of manufacturing of our product. So manufacturing expenses, again repeat, divide in direct expenses and indirect expenses, these two part. The direct expenses means material, labor and other direct expenses. Those are directly affected on our manufacturing process. Indirect expenses means not essential but used, but spend money on that particular product, it should be also increases our cost. So manufacturing expenses means our cost, and cost means addition of material, addition of labor, addition of other expenses, addition of factory overhead, addition of office overhead and selling distribution overhead. These are indicate the our cost of product which is produced by ourselves. The actual pro forma is given. How to prepare the cost sheet? So pro forma of cost sheet. So there is two part, direct expenses and indirect expenses. So first item, consumed material, means without material we cannot start our process of manufacturing. And how to calculate consumed material? Like this. Opening stock of raw material plus purchases of raw material plus outcry, garage, cartage, dock charges, purchases, all various expenses, it and subtracted from closing stock of raw material means which material not used in our manufacturing process, and as well as there is a scrap, there is a wastage, that wastage and sale of byproduct, these are less from our total cost of material, and finally we define the consumed material. So first head, as per cost sheet, consumed material. Second is direct wages, means expenses on various type of labor, skilled, semi-skilled, unskilled. And third is other direct expenses, means expenses spent on equipment, loose tools related to machinery, that is in the other direct expenses. And the addition of these three head is known as prime cost. Prime means main. Prime means a main cost of our manufacturing process, therefore it is known as direct expenses. So second part, indirect expenses, means not essential, but manufacturer spend money on that particular head. So first, factory and work overhead. Factory is also known as work, and overhead is known as indirect expenses, means meaning of overhead is indirect expenses. So various type of expenses spent on factory activity, like a differentiation of machinery, oil, fuel, gas, electricity, these are related to the expenses for factory. And the factory overhead, total factory expenses, increases our cost of manufacturing, and this addition is known as work cost. It is also known as factory cost, but standard level it is known as work cost. Work means factory. So another head is office and administrative overhead. When manufacturers spend money on maintaining a systematic office, and office there is a salary, there is a remuneration, there is an electric bill, various types of expenses which are related to maintaining office, it should be increases our total cost of manufacturing. And that cost, the addition of our cost, is known as cost of production. So, dear student, cost of production, is another meaning is product is ready for sale. Our product is ready for sale. Is also known as cost of production. There is a finished product, means last year manufacturer produced the articles but not sold. That articles is known as opening stock of finished group goods, and the manufacturer try to sell it. So add the our cost of production. And after all, which product is not sold by current year? That finished goods, that articles is known as closing stock of finished goods, and it should be subtracted from our total cost. And finally, cost received, that is known as cost of goods sold, means after selling that product, the total cost, total expenses, that is known as cost of goods sold. Next, manufacturer sold his article by himself only. So he spent various types of expenses on sale, that is advertisement, shop, commission, bad debts, credit sale. These are items which is related to selling and distribution process, and that expenses again increases our cost of product. And finally, the cost which is defined as a cost of sale. This cost is known as cost of sale, means after complete the process from manufacturing to sale, the cost becomes known as cost of sale. It is also known as total cost. It is also known as total cost. And compared to our selling price, the difference between cost and sale is known as our profit. And this is the standard statement of cost sheet and tender. So again repeat, the pro forma of cost sheet, first consider direct expenses, the three head, the consumed material, direct wages, other direct expenses, the addition of these three main items is known as prime cost. Second, indirect expenses, that is factory, office and selling and distribution, these are indirect expenses, should be added in prime cost and get a total cost of sale. And after comparison of selling price, the difference is known as a profit of our industry. Thank you.